Welcome, everybody. You can hear the blissful waters rolling in the background. It is because we are here for day number two of the defense. That is right. We defend the beautiful, placid waters of the creek that does split our Dota map into twain. Of course, on the other side of those river is going to be our two opponents. Once I'll be failed micro, they will be up on the dire side. It is the side of all pure evil going up against the side of light and all things that are good. And that will be SK Gaming, known to the world as Monkey beforehand. The known to the world before that with a slightly different roster as Next Evolution, the team from the International. They will be appearing today. You can hear it already coming on the background, which is Radiant the Dire team bands. Radiant team bands is the Banning Sage. This is our wonderful time of the draft. That's right. You can. Someone should make a show called The Draft. An interesting concept. Okay, let's have a look at our band so far. So Broodmother as well as Lich being taken out. Nightstalker instantly being ripped out from the Dire. Obviously, Fell Micro realized that SK loved to gank and they loved to push. So more than likely, you see Prophet coming out as their second last, their second band. Interesting, actually, Broodmother being banned out here by SK. Just wondering right now, too, because I know Link does really love to actually play that Broodmother, but he also loves to play the Anti-Mage, and that's probably what's going through Dire's head right now. SK have first pick. We can only ban out one. Is it going to be Anti-Mage, or is it actually going to be Prophet? But then again, there's so many other big agi carries which can be picked up that it could really make some issues. And there's our Prophet, so they are trying to bait the Anti-Mage pick out first from SK. And maybe look for a little VR. Hello, Omni Knight instead. Omni Knight, okay. So I did actually see SK use its up against. They were actually playing a scrim game going up against Virus, actually. Or New French Order, now Team Shakira. We actually played pretty decently last night. If you missed it, check out the VODs at joinDOTA. But yeah, they actually played an Omni Knight lane up against. I'm actually trying to remember what they actually combined Omni Knight with. I think it's actually Omni Knight as well as Pudge, which is always a great combination. When you throw a Pudge hook out, you bring someone in, and then Omni Knight drops the heal right on top of Pudge. Pudge gets the heal from the rot, which he already just lost a life from, as well as damaging the hero that's actually right next to Pudge. Great combination for good ganking. Even though two melee heroes, they do actually have that range damage, depending on who is actually where. So it's all about positional play for those boys. And I love how Captain Crunch actually remembers the 5 Necro books. And it was actually something that was done in that. They actually had 5 scrim matches. You actually can find it when Link was actually streaming before. They were actually having some great times. They played 5 matches in a row. And it was actually Virus ended up winning 3. Actually, no, Virus won 2. But the third one was pretty close. And then the other two went pretty convincingly towards Monkey. So there were actually a couple of options between them for, like, who is going to be better. I'm going to be better. You're going to be better. I'm going to be better. And in the end, it said, okay, we're both just good. Still, we're going to see these guys appearing at DreamHack. Both of those teams actually appearing. As far as Fell Micro, at this point, they might be able to actually go to DreamHack, but they will have to fight their way through the round of 64. Dire actually picking up Windrunner as well as Beastmaster. So side solo, possibly mid solo, possibly both side solos. We have actually seen that coming out a lot with the Beastmaster when he's picked for the Dire side, actually being thrown towards the top lane. That way they can see if the gank is going to come around the side by level 2. You've already got your Greater Hawk and already one level on your Axis too, so if you need to get yourself out very, very fast, you can actually do that. So he does have that option. Not a bad option too. I always do prefer Beastmaster going inside the mid-river. That way you can really control off those runes very, very nicely. That's a simple bottle. Means early farm is required, but you can do that with the Axis. You just got to try and control your farm off a little bit more.
Anti-Mage.
Crap, Anti-Mage. Anti-Mage now coming up for the Radiant side. You now know who Link will be playing. Link, probably one of the most insane farmers in the world of European Dota 2 right now. I love it. Thank you very much, Scumbag. I'm not actually meaning that as an insult. That's his name. Well, Scumbaggy is your name. That's right. I can see the ISC every single time I look over this way. I'm actually watching what you guys are actually saying, just so I can actually communicate with you guys. Because it's all about talking to the listener. We all know what happens when Toby ignores his listeners. Thread start up on Ghosty Gamers. In the meantime, there's actually a thread also on the joinDOTA forums. There's actually a vote currently over at IGN of what MOBA. They use the word MOBA. What Dota clone game do you play the most? And at this point, League of Legends is winning. I think we better get ourselves over there and actually post up. So if you want the link, check out the joinDOTA forums. The thing is actually there. So Dota Pride. Vengeful Spirit coming up here from the Radiant. Not a bad choice, probably because they're probably thinking Dire if they do try and pick up Enigma. We're always going to have VS, Beastmask, and easily get caught out as well. Windrunner. She can Windrun away, but if she's swapped back, then basically all the effects of the Windrun goes completely out the window and doesn't really help. How can LoL win a victory? I ask myself the same question, Evil Bunny. I ask myself exactly the same question, but obviously LoL is winning right now by about 500 votes. So if we get maybe a third of the people, in fact, yeah, a third of the people who are currently watching this stream vote on that poll, then, hey, Dota goes back to its point where it should be. Venomancer comes up as the last one for the Dire. So they were looking for that kind of push, which I was thinking they might be using Enigma for, but Venomancer not a bad choice for that as well. So Venomancer able to create that big wall of wards. The only downside is, though, if someone gets caught in, they're like getting slowed up by Venomancer, you throw that repel on, and then anti-mage, it's all hunky-dory from that point. It's like, hey, Venomancer ulti, Venomous Gale, poison when you normally attack me, And yeah, life goes pretty nicely after that point. Bans coming out now from the Radiant. We have our hard carries being removed. Not surprisingly, too, because that's all the Dire really have to pick up. So Faceless Void being the first one taken out. And fair enough, too. For me, I always do class Faceless Void as the only guy who can really go toe-to-toe with the Anti-Mage without actually having any form of support. The only downside right now is for the Dire, the Dro Ranger will probably be banned out as well, and that will be the other big counter towards the Radiant side. As far as DPS goes, and also as far as like mid-game potential goes for them, if they picked up a Dro Ranger, should be massively effective during that middle part of the game. And that is basically when Omni Knight really needs to be massively effective as well. But if you're going up against a Windrunner, a Beastmaster, and also Venomancer, all of them are really, really powerful for support ganking, as well as pushing, as well as basically anything you want to do. The mid-game is just their time. But yeah. Dro Ranger probably our last ban coming out from the Radiant. More also pointing out the fact that Dro Ranger does actually have that silence too. That will stop AM from actually being able to blink away, Omni Knight from actually casting anything he wants to as well, unless he has a repel. I don't think the silence actually goes to repel, but I'm sure a lot of the guys in the IRC. Thank you very much, Brilliant. I don't know if I have actually said actually that actually much. Actually didn't fit in the end of that. Yes. But yeah, maybe the guys in IRC can actually help out. If actually Dro Ranger's silence will go through the repel of Omni Knight. What choice for everybody. It goes through magic. It does go through magic immunity. Okay, there we go. That's the call coming out from Sidret. We'll see if Sidret is actually going to be correct. It doesn't. No. Okay, now everyone is now just disagreeing with Dro Ranger. It disables items and spells. Okay, now the guys in the IRC chat can now have that conversation until somebody can actually 100% prove me are wrong. Well trolled, sire. All right, well done, Terratan. Our last man was actually Spectra, so they have taken out, actually more of a defensive carry. Surprising the Radiant actually did that too, considering Spectra. 5 seconds. Spectra's not going to do that much damage, and the Dire's got to look for a big damaging agility hero. You know when you're going up against Omni Knight, or you're going up against Anti-Mage, who will want to run out all the freaking time away from the battles, and if he doesn't run, he'll just get swapped. Life is easy for him. Then a hero like Spectre will be like, well, I'm going to haunt you, but that's, I'm going to half-track you down, then you're just going to blink away. I can obviously just shadow my walker over the edge of cliffs to actually follow you. Puck now coming up from the Radiant side. Wow, they really would have wanted that Crystal Maiden right now. They're not going to get it, though, but they will have some Rings of Basilius, more than likely. I'm looking towards Omni Knight. Hard to help out the Puck, but that's their side lane solo at least. So you might see a Puck on Windrunner. I always feel massively sorry for Puck just when it comes to that point. Because Windrunner can harass so easily. I always find the attack animation of Windrunner is so much easier than Puck's to actually keep the harassment going. And then you get the power shots right, but then of course phase shifts. If you miss those, timing is all about the battle of the minds when it comes to those two lanes going head-to-head. And we might see that as well. We might see Windrunner on Puck on that top lane, considering Tidehunter and Venomancer have both come up now for the Dire. We might actually see them hovering themselves around on that bottom lane and be a little bit more aggressive towards that bottom lane, which I really hope they are going to do, because I know Link would just be on that bottom lane so many times and just free farming. And it keeps on happening. But then again, saying that, I also remember that SK do love to actually play Anti-Mage on the top lane, even as Radiant. No matter what happens, they want to play him on that top lane because, well, basically, you're never really expecting to actually run the tri-lane against the top lane. It doesn't really happen unless all you want to do is try and shut down that side lane solo, which is going to be Puck, at which point you go, well, it's going to be hard enough for me to actually kill him. Ricky Maru for the Dire? Okay, well, those that are agi damage. Also, actually, not a bad pick when it comes to think about it. Wish Doctor was the last with the radium. But Riggy Maru with that smoke cloud. So we still get the silence I was actually asking for from Drow Ranger. It comes through the cloud. The only downside about it is once the cloud's actually cast, I think there's basically about a quarter of a second where you can actually blink away before the silence will actually take effect on you. And if Anti-Mage is fast, I mean, it's Link, he will be fast, then he can actually, well, basically stop any issues and just blink himself away. Yeah, Ricky was about... You are right there, Deep. However you say your name. Ricky was basically the only logical choice. Except for Drow. I like Drow, man. Drow was good. Either of them would have worked. Personally, I would have still actually liked to prefer Drow. Mainly because Drow range actually has that range attack early on. It'll be a little bit easier to go head-on-head with the anti-mage. The only problem is when he comes in close. But then again, you're a right-click hero. When you look at Riggy Maru, Riggy Maru is also a right-click hero, but he can't really face the anti-mage head-on-head. But that's why he just smoke, forces the anti-mage to actually walk out of the smoke, and then he turns his back to you, and you get the backstab pluses. So Riggy will be heading on towards the top lane. Venomance will be giving him support, so more than likely just pulling and ensuring that how low top tri lane. Here we go. SKR going to do it. So they're going to run the Omni Knight. I think I might actually switch in towards the mid lane a little bit later on, but it will be Ryze as well as Calculus, the Witch Doctor as well as Ventral Spirit, supporting Angel, of all people actually, playing the Anti-Mage. Which means we're going to see Link actually playing the Puck on the bottom lane. Very, very surprising to see him actually coming out of his hard carry role of the Anti-Mage. And we'll throw him in as the Puck. Venomance is going to be massively disappointed. Radiant Ward will stop that creep pull. The battle begins. So life won't be easy for him, but we'll have Miguel heading in towards the middle lane. So you might actually see dual lanes coming out here from SK, though. We'll pick up that DD rune to start with. Cackles will like that. Actually, Miguel, is he actually going to solo at the mid? They are expecting Beastmaster to be there, and they're going to get that too. So they can run melee on melee in the mid. And maybe that is the reason why we are seeing that double range, what is going to be suppressant on the top lane against the Venomancer and SA, and as well as Angel up there. Which leads Windrunner versus Puck, so my solo versus solo did actually end up coming to fruition. But Link playing the soloer. I would actually say that is his normal role, but a lot of the time when Link actually plays the carry, he is supported very early on. It's like what's happening up here on the top lane. You got Calculus and Ryze really supporting up Angel. Also just realized that volume's just a little bit too loud for that. So we'll just drop that down a little bit. But Angel's going to have a hard time up on the top lane if they decide to initiate on him. There's no level on backstab just yet. It's just that level on the blink strike. But if Angel does get caught out, I mean, basically need a level 3 on that Riggy Maru before he can actually hold the anti-mage in place. A Gush as well as a Venomancer Gale. Yeah, sure, that's a crap load of slow on Angel. But you got a stun from Calculus and you got a bounce stun from Witch Doctor. So even if you decide to actually dive it, it's still not going to help you. Babar time. Yeah, actually a little bit lucky there with Miguel coming in a little bit too close towards the tower, taking a couple of hits, but he's still at full mana. Full mana, so two on the purification. That's a lot of damage early on as well as normal heal. Also having one level on the Degen Aura very early on, so just try and actually slow, as well as just slowly bring Beastmaster down over time. Miguel will be forced back. Now that Boar is up, the slow is up, so he's going to be a little bit more careful about going in nice and close. Which is where he obviously needs to be, being two melees. And that's the reason why Beastmaster is always a great hero to run towards the mid. Also for his Hawks, we do actually see our next rune. It's going to be an Invis for the top. Radiant have vision of that. There's the Hawk on that bottom lane watching the bottom. Bottom rune. So Beastmaster does know the runes on top. He doesn't actually have that bottle just yet, but hello bottle. So I want to pop that off a couple of times. He does have his own ward up on the high ground here, so they can watch that rotation from Miguel in towards the middle, but Miguel at this point doesn't look like he actually cares. His bottle is now only just coming out to him now, so as far as the bottle racers go, Babar time has it. He can spam out all these abilities to actually harass Miguel down. In fact, Miguel instantly coming through and healing, but he's got to be really careful that Babar doesn't actually pop off that TD and have a go at him. Probably realized he had those bottle charges in, but it's going to be a little bit of a waste for him to have to use those so early on, especially if he doesn't pick up that 4-minute rune. So this mid-battle, we have to watch it every 2 minutes when the rune spawns. We'll watch where they actually head, see what rune they actually do pick up. In the meantime, we'll actually check out our CS score to see how we're going for SK. Is 13 for 3, Miguel. really leading that way in the middle lane. Manicus Beastmaster hasn't always been in that middle lane. Has been rotating up, picking up the rune, or going back, picking up the bottle, giving Miguel a little bit more extra space to either deny his own creeps or to actually get those last hits in. Then Linker 13-3 going up against Windrunner. It's 15-4. That's what I'm talking about with that attack animation of Windrunner. For me, it's just a little bit smoother to actually use than it is the puck. And to have someone actually out CSing Link is actually surprising. Like, if you actually seen the screenshots he posts up on Facebook, where his goal per minute sitting up around 1,200. But that's generally when he's playing an anti-mage, and that will basically flood him once he starts getting those kills. And then early battle fury just basically transition from creep camp to creep camp. And then the last one I want to check out is Angel on top lane. 17-3 for the anti-mage, and SA is actually 13-3. It's actually not as bad as I thought it could have actually been. And for me, SA, you can see you got one on every single one. He needs to get that first blood in the top. It needs to happen. Hello, Miguel. Be a little bit careful. Luckily for him, Babar is not level 6. Even then, I doubt he'll actually pop off his ultimate. But the rune, the 4-minute rune, does go towards that Beastmaster once again. So Omni-Knight has nothing in his bottle, which gives Babar even more space to actually move. And the board just keeps harassing, keeps the vision up. Mission's taken away. Which makes it a lot easier. Hello, in the meantime, smoke has actually happened on the top lane. So an attempt at the initiation. Venomancer has already fallen back. But that's that simple blink. Actually, even then, Anti-Mage hasn't used blink. He must just walk straight back out of the smoke. Obviously, you can't blink out of smoke. The smoke does actually add a miss percentage chance. As well as that silence. Silence being the primary thing, but when Angel is trying to slice at you, if he keeps on missing, Ricky doesn't miss out in that manner. He can actually keep blinking. He can actually keep using that smoke, which is pretty expensive for him as well. For a hero with only 240 mana pool. Oh, Baba. He's not level 6 yet. I mean, I'm actually still not leveling him. Doesn't matter if you have a bottle charge. If Miguel is the one still actually getting these last hits and getting the farm, life will not matter after that point. Level 6 now for Windrunner. Doesn't really matter for her. She never ever levels up her ultimate. In fact, for the first level, actually going on Windrun. So a very aggressive there by ET. 3 levels on the power shot. Oh, hello, activating. So it looks like Miguel did decide to actually go on Babar in the meantime. Watching Angel as well on that top. But yeah, I was talking about the 3 levels on power shot, 2 levels on shackle. Generally, you will see a early level on Windrun, even as your first ability, just because you fear that gank, but because the tri-lane's up on the top, Windrun just felt a little bit more secure. Especially going one-on-one with a Puck, it's like, well, Puck's not really going to be able to initiate, I mean, without some form of help. And even then, you probably reckon you could out-DPS them, or at least land yourself a good shackle. You got a lot of trees in that bottom lane to actually shackle the Puck to. The only thing you got to be careful about is the phase shift, but that interruption of attack will be more than enough to help you escape. Illusion. So in the meantime, Angel, just trying to get a little bit of farm on the Venomancer wards. Massive's got to be a little bit careful throwing these guys out. There's extra money on that top lane to throw at them. As he goes from Dire's mana to Radiant's gold. They don't want to give too much of that away, but they also want to keep that vision. That's why we saw that ward being dropped off just on the side. So if we do see Hello Gush, no blink. The Gale will hit, though. They don't chain off at the same time, so Cataclysm is just slowed for an extended period of time, not all at the once. Those slows, of course, do actually stack. Bounce Dun will now fly. Massive's got to be a little bit careful. Smoke does come in. It's all about the SA, but the first blight goes on the Venomancer. Puck Ultimate also coming up towards the top. Held the Rookie Maru in place. So SK not only spilled one blood, they spilled two. One for the Witch Doctor, and also one for the Puck in the end, too. So Angel got nothing. Well, it does take Puck out of that top, out of that bottom lane. It looks like he's actually walking all the way back. There's 900 gold himself, but Windrunner is buying some time to farm. So great start there for SK, getting the first blood. Probably a little bit of overextension, you have to say, by the SA. Kind of realized that Witch Doctor, that the support hero Venomancer was in a little bit of trouble. There we go, blinking in again. So, well, there goes the blink back out again. Smoke just coming a little bit too late there from Ricky. And they do get held in place by that bounce son of the Witch Doctor. Little to no creeps of their own, the Dire. So I've got a full burst of it. Speaking of burst, completely missing there from Massive. So Angel doesn't get much harassment. The wave gets it instead. So they'll just push the wave out a little bit further. She gets a little bit more room to where she breathes. And there's Ryze going to pick up the money from the ward. As you can see, 17 extra gold, which normally you would not be giving to the other team. Say, trying to get any form of farm he can. In the meantime, Miguel's actually having a little bit of fun on that middle lane. Being left by himself again, and it's because Beastmaster's actually walked all the way back to the main base. Better be buying a TP scroll to get himself back out there soon. Still got to say it's impressive for ET from the amount of farm he's actually got. Link wants to initiate. Puck ultimate. Angel's going to burn off the mana. Windrunner does get stunned. Orb as well as the Warning Rift. Beastmaster's going to be here. Got to get that roar right. We get a small bit of a lag spike. Axes will fly. Will it be enough damage? Yes, it will be from Puck to get the kill on the Windrunner. Link trying to run himself away. Bad about time. Does not have enough mana for another axe. Now he does. He's already popped off a bottle charge. Except he's going to lose it now. He walks into the anti-mage. Tied up is in here as well. But one orb is too much with Angel blinking in as well. Puck gets himself a double kill. So three kills out of the four go to Link playing as the Puck for SK. And a foul micro being tested on multiple lanes. Now that Angel's down that bottom lane. She's got Witch Doctor. So we're going to go Moose style Witch Doctor on that top lane. AKA support carry is what we call the Moose style Witch Doctor. Also known to the world as Moosing. When you steal the farm from your hard carries. But the hard carry's on the bottom lane, so Anti-Mage is having fun down there. It's going to be actually a little bit more careful. Windrunner, she's going to deal a fair amount of damage to him. So will be forced back, as you can see. That Ring of Health, it can deal with normal harassment, but for actually a farmed hero, that's not normal harassment. That forces you back a little bit further than you really anticipate. Meantime, searching out for that 10-minute rune. It will be that bottom lane. So once again, rune control does go towards that Beastmaster. It's probably the reasons why he hasn't actually not died. Yeah, he hasn't died at all. But from the rune control, he's got 16 for 1 for his CS. Ricky at 40 for 6, 51 for 12. And his opponent, Miguel, on the middle, 55 for 19. There's just a lot of not being there. In the meantime, sorry, kill on the top lane. Link has actually dived that one. They want to get massive as well. Support stun. There we go. Magic missile will be enough. Gush trying to slow down Calculus. And while the creep wave's up next to the tower, they won't really fear too much. But it's another double kill for Link, which now makes it 5 for him. So in the meantime, Angel. Gotta feel a little bit sorry for him on that bottom lane. I guess I'm going to feel pretty happy for him, considering how all the other lanes are going. Windrunner can't stick around here forever. She can get a decent amount of farm, but... Oh, hello, Angel. Say hello to ET, man. He was just lining up for the creep wave. Got himself a bonus. Tries to land the shackle shot. Might be able to actually get another power shot. No. He thought he might blink up, but Angel actually blinked back towards the creep wave. So ET going for a couple of guest power shots. Not a bad choice for them as well. Also going to see Beastmaster helping out the top lane. He's actually up here himself. Well, hello. Small little spikes on the server. But just having this crow over here, they can see Link just hanging up next to that tower. And his ultimate's off cooldown in 1 and now 0 seconds. So we might decide to actually initiate. Maybe on the middle lane, because Babar Time is currently on the run. Calculus will look for the initial stun. There goes the first stun. He is not level 6 just yet, so there's no swap available. But that DJ Nora really slowing Babar down. And Invis Rune, don't let him pick it up! Lands the Roar! The Invis Rune is still sticking there. Orb goes out, Ventral Spirit goes down. Windrunner with a good shackle as well as Power Shot to actually pick up that kill. And now the Invis Rune goes towards the Beastmaster. And Miguel, for some unknown reason, is actually up on the top of a hill. I don't know if he actually got pushed up there by something. Is there a 4-star in the field? I don't think there was. Who the hell actually saw that? But Miguel is stuck. He has no TP scroll. And there is currently, well, trying to heal and repel himself up there. Four heroes trying to bring him down. Ricky is thinking about blinking up there, but if he does, he's going to get himself caught. He does, but now he's caught. And the Radiant can, well, the Radiant would be able to see him up there if they had himself a sentry. But one of these heroes has got to stick around a little bit longer for him to blink himself back down again. There we go. I don't know if it was, I think it was the Beastmaster Roar that actually pushed him up. Yeah, it was the Rexxar ulti. It's the only thing that could have actually done that. And just shoved him up. So in the end, two kills do actually go the way of a foul micro. And more than likely in the middle tower as well. The Mancer Wards was like level three wards. He's not level seven yet. So we won't see our full level wards. TP's gonna come in. Who is it gonna be? Ravage has got to come out from Tidehunter. He must pop that Ravage. He does do so. Puck tried to phase shift. It wasn't in time. But Babba, great Puck Orb. A lot of damage. Beastmaster and Venomancer already going down. It's actually Omnite and Witch Doctor who got the two kills. Picking up the Crow on the way out. But Windrunner very, very fast on foot with that Windrun ability to get out. In the meantime, Angel hasn't even left that bottom lane. In fact, now just blinks. Straight up to Windrunner. Thought he could actually suck enough mana out of the Windrunner. But she put on that evasion, and after that, it was just like, yeah, cool. Angel wants to try and bring down that bottom lane. Get rid of these tier 1 towers. Still no tier 1 towers claimed by SK. And that's something they've got to be mindful of, too. To have a lot of these frontal positions still up and running for foul micro. It's not something they can really allow. Like, we're going to see that. I'm not really massively surprised by the fact that it was 3,000 gold difference. TP comes in. Who's it going to be? Tide is in. No Ravage. And actually tries to go for the deny. Why? Oh, son of a why? Beastmaster will come up. The heal is not actually going to be enough to kill off the Tidehunter. Actually healing off the illusion there. To actually try and get the kill on Tidehunter, who manages to live with the help of Majestic Charges at 17 HP. Beastmaster was probably thinking about his ultimate. In the end, did the wise maneuver and didn't actually pop it. Illusion's not dead just yet. That Beastmaster Rax is still level 3. It only did that much damage to the Omni-9? Alright, I'll go with that. I'll be careful too. We're going to see Omni-9 probably pick up a gem sometime soon. Once that gem is up, that's generally the biggest problem SA is going to have. Who is actually going to counter him with either gem, wards, dust? Really, I'd probably prefer a gem for the SK lineup, considering they do have a lot of heal on their sleeves. So Wish Doctor through his Voodoo Restoration, who has actually not put a single... He's got two levels on it. Beastmaster Roar, I'm hearing. Anti-Mage is going to be the one to go down, so Shackle was able to hold him in place long enough. Windrunner actually got the kill, so Windrunner comes down towards the bottom lane. Ryze is here with Link. So Link does have his ultimate up. Fel Micro realize they can't get caught next to this tower. Axis will fly. They would really love to push out this bottom lane, but SK, the Witch Doctor, as well as the Puck, doing the right thing, just delaying the creep wave down to buy time for Miguel and Calculus to attack on the tier 1 tower on the top lane. And it is brought down by Omni-Knight. And now bottom lane initiation. Link actually able to phase shift through not only the Gush, but also the Shackle Shot. Tidehunter in a lot of trouble, already taking a lot of damage from the orb. Massive trying to help out. Now we're going to see Link's actually dropping his ultimate, but Ryze also! Big ultimate! Puck gets himself a double. Witch Doctor gets himself one. Negative earn charge from Miguel, trying to slow down the Windrunner. He will be able to retreat back past the Tier 1 tower, but the Tier 1 tower will go down. Oh, hello, SA. He has that double damage rune. If he wanted to go for this, it is actually possible. He's got two heroes to actually get through, though. He probably wants to fight next to his tower, but that DD rune's going to wear out. And the Andy TP's up towards the top lane for more farm. You can just see how desperate he is to stay alive. Strength treads, not wanting to crank everything he's got into agility. Agility is where he gets his strength, obviously, being an agility hero. He's got the blade as well as the poor man's shield. So a little bit of extra agility, a little bit of extra evasion. And that's basically where it ends. If he does get a fair amount of farm, if he gets more farm than Anti-Mage, then he's going to be looking good. But you look at Anti-Mage's farm right now at 74 for 16. Has got one death as well as four assists. Where you look at the Rikimaru, one kill, two deaths. As well as zero assists, 72 for 15. Actually, not bad for farm. The bigger problem is this guy. The Vanguard at Omni-Knight. Now thinking about the mid. Puck's just going to orb up, so get a little bit of vision up there. The armor have omniscience. Say hi to the masses. Repel going off from Omni-Knight. Just a little bit fearful of the initiation to come out from Foul Micro. They're currently pushing out the mid lane. It's a bit of a hard lane for them to push, though, considering they've only got a tier 2 tower to actually kill, so that's the only advantage they will get from that middle lane if they push. Either that or they are going to look for a kill. The Greater Hawk having a bit of a move around. They will see Miguel coming up. They have the vision for it. Wait for the Shackle. ET's in the perfect position for it right now. Moved himself out a little bit further, but gets silent, so he can't let it go. Bounce done also holding Babar in time. Babar in position. The heal, the Rebel goes up, but the Ravage from the Tidehunter will actually hold enough of the SK players in place that they might be able to pick off one of them, even though Windrunner and Beastmaster have already gone down. Venomancer gets one. Omni-Knight gives the return kill, and then Link also comes in, finishes off the Tidehunter. Only person to live is the farming up SA on the top lane. And he's going on one-on-one with Angel. Bit of a balls up. Bit of a balls up coming out there from Foul Micro. That Windrunner Shackle really needed to come out sooner. But the second Puck jumped in there was able to let off that silence. It was just, well, what can you really do when you can't use any of your abilities? And it was a good silence as well. Just shut them down. The Ravage bought them some time to actually get at least one form of revenge kill, but that was basically it. There goes the bottom tower, so Angel actually missing the deny for that. It's almost like depressing music was just started up from the Dota 2 client. Kind of just knew, it's like, oh Angel, what were you doing, Angel? Probably been a little bit hard with the creep camp that's actually there. As far as we got Perseverance, so going the normal Battle Fury build. With the amount of time he's getting on the bottom lane, almost every single hit on that bottom lane wave was his. And you see that farm just jumping up 102 for 21 right now. Going massively above the SA. That's going to be SA's problem keeping up. Really got to switch to that Agi. If he's gonna get caught up, then he's going to get caught out. It's just going to happen. He's going to have to be forced to actually turn and fight. No one's got a gem. Blink actually coming off here from Link. Already with the silence, landed off the ultimate. Beastmaster is royally screwed. The heal from Miguel did the majority of the damage, and then the illusionary orb finishing off Babar. Just getting caught out of position. Is that Cactus throwing out a stun on a creep? Actually, no, it was on the Hawk. It's like, there's no way you'd be just stunning a creep. There's no hero there. But the Hawk was the main thing. A little bit of extra money for him, worth the mana to actually expend. In the meantime, Angel does actually have enough to complete up the Battle Fury. I don't know if he's actually going to do it, though. At this point, I wouldn't be surprised if he actually just grabs the ultimate orb and tries to go towards Manta. Doesn't really need that excess amount of farm for himself right now. They're already keeping good pressure on. And as far as like winning the team fights, if they keep winning those, like, you can help out with the Battle Fury. Well, bye-bye, Ricky. And there's that dust I was talking about. Eventual Spirit, yep, dust charge. Now Titan is also called out. Sends in the Hawk. Obviously not Titan, it's Hawk, it's Beastmasters. Venomance is also here in Invis. Just harasses Miguel off a little bit. But with his Vanguard on him, he doesn't really care. Also with an ultimate orb. So looks like we're going to be seeing a sheep stick, or pig stick, or frog stick. Coming out from our boy in the armor. The paladin, basically. The Omni-Knight. Angel has actually decided in the end to go to the Battle Fury. Can't really say I'm that surprised. Just kind of hoping for something a little bit different out of the ordinary. As opposed to the standard anti-mage build, which is like farm in a tri-lane, Battle Fury, stick around the jungle, it's just basically jump from here to here to here to here to here to here, and then just keep on going on that. Well, we have Ricky Maru just disconnecting for the moment, so Tanana just poisoned the game quickly. So not quite sure what happened to Shiva. Find out his position. Has he started walking back to the main base? No, he hasn't, so a very, very quick pause means, Basically, whenever you disconnect from a game, you'll automatically run back to the main base, back towards safety. Just a reminder as well that the Na'Vi game will not be played today. Basically, Na'Vi only just got back from the Ukraine, So they are not in any shape to actually play tonight, so they will have their game postponed. Coming up this weekend, though, we have a lot of matches. Also tomorrow, we don't just miss out. So tomorrow we actually have EG going up against Myth Trust, and then SGC versus Eben. We still actually need to confirm both these games. As you can imagine, there's a lot going on. We're trying to organize matches from multiple continents. So hopefully we'll get those two games happening tomorrow. So Eben being the team, which is actually the word Hon compilation team. So top Hon players from around the world or around Europe, they'll be playing together going up against SGC. And then Myth Trust versus EG. They'll all both be happening tomorrow. Day after for our Saturday, if my brain is going to work for the days. Actually, that means Friday. Anyway, MYM versus File Micro. Also have MUFC versus J4T. EHOME versus Tech. That's right, EHOME will be playing. As well as GDT versus the Wild Honey Badgers. That's all coming up to you on the 19th. So it's not far away. That is the Saturday. So I think we actually have a day off. Saturday night is actually looks like it's actually a bit of a day off for us. So you get to just relax, go out, party with all those young girls who are just such big Dota 2 fans. People love to see the CS table. There you go. It's just for you guys and IRC. So we would actually have a lot of matches coming up. We've also got the qualifiers for the Stars tournament. So that is the $20,000 tournament that will be happening. The playoffs and finals will be played over 3 days, and they'll be done live in Kiev. I should be there personally. I'm trying to organize my visa right now because I'm not a European. Normally, Europeans can just enter Ukraine however they wish to, but I am Australian, so I do require a visa. So hopefully we can get that done in time. Normally, it would actually be pretty easily done, but because I'm actually traveling to Sweden as well as Malaysia, it is causing some issues. But I should actually be there, and I'm hearing, stream is down. That is not something I actually want to see. Stream is not down. What are you talking about? I'm watching the stream right now, man. I just got trolled. They will be running the online qualifiers for the Dota 2 competition coming up this weekend. We'll have them all up on the match ticket so you guys can follow it up there as well. But in the meantime, we do actually have matches coming up, so keep your eyes on the joinDOTA website. You'll see any match whichever happens in Dota 2 up on our match ticker, so you can keep up to date with that. We still don't have SA back in the game. Hopefully it won't be too long before he actually arrives. So we'll just give you a couple more graphs. In the meantime, too, head yourself actually over to joinDOTA. Now, I have been told there is actually a forum post. Hit my right hotkeys. Hi, guys. We're going to be back here. So I'm just going to actually bring up my forums for you. There's actually something which I'd like all of you to actually do. So we can jump you straight back to that window. Over in the forums, I've been told there is actually a place where you can actually vote. It was a post done up by Quartermix. So I need to think everybody actually know about it. Yeah, vote for Dota 2. So if you actually just come in here, so vote for Dota 2. So it's actually in the community pet section of the forums. And basically, IGN are running another poll. Sometimes you just go, meh, it's IGN running another poll. But who's actually winning is going to be the bigger question. So I vote for Dota 2. And at this point, Dota 2 is not winning. League of Legends is winning. We cannot stand for this, people. We cannot stand for League of Legends winning this. Shout out to all the League of Legends people who are currently tuning in. Love you guys. With an affection unspeakable. But there is Dota Pride on the line. So come over here and actually vote for the... Wow, poor Heroes of New Earth. Yes, go over to the forums and vote for that one. It will be much appreciated by everybody. So everybody go and vote. There's currently 2,630 people watching this stream. So if everybody from this stream does go over there and actually vote right now, yay! Then we basically dominate the entire IGN poll. Be like, where the hell do those 2,000 votes come from? I don't know. Maybe somebody just posted on Twitter? Yeah. So yeah, go over and vote. I'm seeing people saying I voted now from the IRC. If you also want to join the IRC, guys, head yourself over. It's on QuakeNet, hashtag joinDOTA. You can also see it from the live stream tab. I don't know if you guys have actually looked at this as well. I'm going to bring this back up again. So the live stream tab, obviously people have actually noticed it's actually on the main page here, but you don't watch from the main page. You click on this little sucker, and it takes you to the live stream tab. Now look at me. I'm there with Breaky CPK. That's good times, actually, in Singapore. We need a new picture. We're going to make some new pictures over the next couple of weeks as I go to different LAN tournaments. If you actually want to just have a look at the chat, show chat, log in. That simple, guys. That simple. Just log yourself in here. Maybe it's not some great times. Even see the upcoming broadcast. And all the streamers actually have this too. So actually, Link is actually not streaming right now. So he's actually not streaming while he's actually playing. But you can check out all the live streams here. So for anybody who's actually going to be streaming, if you want to check out Volat, Volat's over here too. And he's actually not live right now, but you can actually create your own reminders. So if you actually want to know when Volat's going to go live, or myself, you can actually just hit create reminder, and it'll basically just give you a pop-up on the joinDOTA website, letting you know that something is coming up. For the guys saying the stream is down, it is not down. I can see it moving on my side screen. Yeah. Just refresh it, guys. Control-F5 is your friend. Control-F5 is your friend. Wow. I don't know about you, but casting makes me hot. I don't know like what you actually get when you sit at home just going, yeah, watching a match. Sorry for ping. Why are we sorry for the ping? Oh, because I'm actually, well, I have actually been lagging off a little bit. Oh no. Link just pinged the map. Okay. Just so you guys know, so you never actually do it when you actually have a pause in the game. If you're actually sitting here just going do 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 do, and the game is paused, if you actually ping across the map, it will actually, well, it doesn't actually stop. Like, all the pings happen at one time. So if everybody on the map actually pings, you get all 10 or however many pings all at the one time going out. It's actually kind of painful. I also just realized, ow! Oh! Yep, I didn't need those ear canals. Woo! Oh. Great. I didn't realize there's that many pings on the map. All right, in the meantime, hello, Angel. Unable to actually latch the shackle shot, so he just blinks himself away to safety. So what makes anti-mage to that slippery little sucker. It's almost impossible to actually catch him at any point of the game. Early, middle, late game. There's actually a discussion about how overpowered anti-mage is right now. The battle's going to be happening from the opposite side. The Radiant's on the Dire side. The Dire's on the Radiant. Gale goes off. Ravage goes off. He's already up inside. The big Ultimate of Rise. He is just standing there. It's a turkey slap in the middle. Angel blinks back up. Try and take out Windrunner. Already trying to burn off the mana. Angel's taking too much damage. It's forced to fall back. In the meantime, Titan's about to go down. The Malediction will get in the kill. Rise with a triple freaking kill. They want to get one more. Link is the one to pick off the Windrunner. Windrunner trying to actually do the fast-footed away. But that battle just went very, very randomly in the wrong direction. And I say wrong direction because both the teams tried to rotate around. So we saw the Radiant go around this way and the Dire went around this way. And in the end, they were fighting from the opposite sides of the river. So the push will now come on the mid. Someone's got themselves a 4-star, pushing Link to facepalm the tower. They probably won't push it any further. I love how now all the players are now actually drawing on the map. Oh, great. Thanks, guys. Thanks. So now Angel heads down towards the bottom lane. Able to live through that, but you can already see with the center regen he's got, which does come out from the Battle Furious, the reason for the Perseverance, especially the reason for the early Ring of Health. There you go, SK. SA. He's waiting for one hero to be caught out. But there's three here. He might better get the cloud. Ty's trying to play the bait right now to try and bring them down. There is still that dust on Calculus. So if they do bump into him, I think Miguel just did. Miguel just bumped into the SA, so off goes with the Howl of Terror. They have no stun, but they do have a Puck Ult. He has called out three Beastmaster Roar. Tries to actually, and does actually hold Elminite in place, but once again, Ryze throws down the big ultimate. Babar Time taking a lot of damage from that. No one's gone down just yet. Babar Time decides to actually do the crazy thing and run back in towards the mix. Off goes the dust. Rookie Maru showed himself. And now he's trying to bring down Calculus. Does successfully do so. Gets himself a double kill. Will get orb to death, if not power shot it. But it's actually going to be the orb. Obviously can't Dotto his own friend's power shot. Ryze trying to just be a boss. Trying to bring down the Venomancer. With a couple of wards there, Shackle Shot actually latches. Lines up the power shot. Take out a decent amount of his life. In the meantime, though, anti-mage having a little bit of fun. Restoration, trying to keep Ryze alive. Does successfully do so. That Ghost Scepter makes it so Windrunner can't attack. And means that he actually has enough time to actually heal himself up. Angel, good blink. There's only a very, very small gap in the trees for him to actually, for Windrunner to actually walk through that time. No more wind run. Decides to actually kill off the boar angel in the end. Realizing that's what's slowing him down, so he can't pursue that wind runner. Angel will just push out their bottom lane. Once again, and this is always something which I always get a couple of cringes about. And there's a Vladimir. Vladimir's offering on anti-mage isn't too bad, but a heart is just so much more effective. And when you get the amount of farm that Angel has actually got, if we get a late game, and he's got himself a Vlad, he'll be like, oh crap, why don't I actually buy that? And SA is the one getting some kills. And getting control of this game back again. You can lose the game that way. And yes, guys, I do actually know Ricky actually... I should have actually pointed that one out. Ricky is actually not back in the game. He can't reconnect back into the game. So at this point, it is actually a 4v5. And they're actually going to call the GG. They don't want to play a 4v5 in the end. They realize they can't win this, and they're only just basically drawing out the inevitable. So if every player actually disconnects from the dire side, then it will officially be done and we'll go into our beautiful animation. In the meantime, they're just trying to get some easy kills on the Windrunner. So Venomancer is the only one, massive. Just hanging out there in the middle lane, hopefully just hasn't walked away from his keyboard because this needs to actually finish officially, properly. That's massive, actually just auto-attacking, so that's not actually him alive. There we go, now he disconnects. So we get our official screen at the end, which says the game was completed in 27 minutes and what will probably be 45 seconds by the time it goes, hey, everyone actually has disconnected. 45, 46, 47, oh my god, the counter just keeps going. Dire's top tower is under attack. That'll be your final score, so we do see SK taking a win in this competition already. So they will actually get themselves 2 points in the group stages. We'll be happy as Larry for that, and there's our automatic victory. The throne explodes into 100 little bits of pebbles. That's right, it's like Tani's home, he plays with his children. That's what's all over the ground, pebbles. Ba-dump. Yeah. In the meantime though, that is actually the end of the broadcasting for this evening. And I gotta say guys, you didn't hit 3.5k, so there's no more songs tonight. As I said yesterday, I'm a man of my word. I sang at 1.5, I sang at 2.5, and now 3.5 is the next goal. We'd never hit that. Maybe tomorrow we will be able to actually hit that point, at which point then I can embarrass myself even more than I already have. So yes, in the meantime, actually, I gotta check the poll. I am being told by people I must check the poll to see how people have actually gone with the votes. We were 18-24 before. Yes! Go the power of Dota! 23-91. It is not high enough yet. Nine more pi- That's not nine. That's nine. I need another hand for nine. Keep those votes going through. It'll become a battle. Who is going to be bigger? Dota 2. Keep those votes flying in for that. I don't know why we're doing this. It's just for good fun. We always have fun here at our Join Dota. Until tomorrow, we've had all our fun for today. So I will see you on the live stream tomorrow night. And if you did miss out on that timing, you can jump yourself straight back over to this page. This is the Join Dota page. Click on the defense tab. Have a look what's actually here. You can see the next two matches coming up. So EG versus Myth Trust will be our first game for tomorrow. If you have not betted yet, please do so. Obviously, you are not really obligated to actually do so. You can do so. You can bet on every single match. All you do is just basically say who you think is going to win. So we actually get people going, this is actually who I think is going to win, not how many tangos can I actually win. So at this point, 75% of people believe Evil Geniuses will take out Myth Trust. Don't actually count out Myth Trust. Myth Trust have been playing pretty nicely over the last couple of times. Just like Myth Trust and MUFC. I always love watching those boys play. But yeah, that'll be happening tomorrow at 18 CET, so 6 p.m. That is basically 22 hours from now. That match will be going live, and they'll be followed up by SGC versus Eben. That'll be happening at 20 CET. Of course, we'll always have some fun in between those two times. We got ourselves some time, man. 2 hours for one game? Not going to happen. We'll have ourselves some time in the middle of it to actually have some fun. I've been told to refresh again. There you go. 2,539. That's more like it. That is a lot more like it. Go the power of Dota. Love you guys. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Thanks for tuning in.